Thousands of years ago, philosophers and scientists believed that the Earth was flat, and in their time, they were right. Today, astronomers are battling with theories like the Big Rip, which says the world will end in a massive explosion, shattering all forms of life and shrinking us into nothingness. Others say time will come to a halt and we will be frozen like a snapshot. Will we ever truly understand how this world came to be or how it'll end? From the beginning of time, humans have been fascinated with the unknown and the unseen. Many believe an unseen world exists due to what has been written in various mythologies and religions. And many scientists have devoted their lives to developing theories to explain certain phenomena, such as a parallel universe and simulated reality. The theory of relativity may have brought understanding to the nature of the universe, but it also had everyone scratching their heads because its consequences are enormous. Dark energy is one example. Einstein's theory of general relativity originally predicted that the universe must either expand or contract. He recognized this in his equations, but saw it as an error rather than a potent prediction. Today, what Einstein called the cosmological constant is what astronomers know as dark energy, the mysterious energy that drives the expansion of the universe, pulling supernovas and galaxies at unexplainable speeds. What do these theories mean for the human race? Join us today as we take you through the most insane to the outrightly bizarre theories you'll ever hear about the cosmos. Our beloved planet, like her sister, could end up in flames. Have you ever wondered why scientists have never really considered Venus habitable, even though it's right next to our planet? That's because Venus is literally the worst place to live. Venus is the hottest planet in the solar system, with 900 degrees Fahrenheit temperatures. Even the clouds are made of highly corrosive sulfuric acid, and the surface pressure is about 92 times the pressure you'd feel at sea level on Earth. What happened to Venus? The Sun is a giant star, and like all stars, it grows brighter, and the habitable zone grows outward as it ages. Venus got trapped in the inner age of the habitable zone. Its surface temperature skyrocketed, oceans dried up, and plate tectonics shut off. Because Venus is made of pretty much the same stuff as our Earth and has roughly the same size and mass, scientists speculate that the Earth could end up like Venus, but not until another 4 billion years. Something is eating the galaxies, including our Milky Way. The Milky Way is losing its companions, and nobody knows why. Findings suggest that something is pulling on these galaxies at an incredible rate, more than 3 million miles per hour. This could mean that they're being pulled towards something very dense, dark, and massive, such as another galaxy or cluster of galaxies. Astronomers had long identified this area of extraordinary gravity as the Great Attractor. But further insights prove that the Great Attractor weighs only a tenth of the mass of 1,000 trillion suns, hence, cannot exert gravity strong enough to pull a galaxy as large as the Milky Way. Some scientists attribute this unusual force to dark flow, a mysterious collective motion of distant galaxy clusters. They claim that since the universe is expanding due to dark energy, only something equally as dark can overcome it. While scientists are debating what the force could be, there is a glaring fact that our planet could be pulled into this abyss within the next 13 billion years and never make it back. There are white holes in space. White holes are the exact opposite of black holes. They don't swallow matter, instead, they spit it out. Science describes it as a time-reversed black hole, a region of space-time where matter spontaneously appears and explodes outwards. They also spit out light and matter, rather than trapping it. This means if a human being got in the path of a white hole, he would be spat out. It's not one, but many universes. You may have seen Doctor Strange make those short trips to several universes in Marvel's Multiverse of Madness, but there are scientific theories to back the fictional movie. Scientists believe that the universe we have come to know may not be the only one out there. There could be more. They call it the multiverse. The concept arises in a few areas of physics, philosophy, and religion, but the most prominent example comes from what scientists describe as the inflation theory, which dates back to the Big Bang inflation theory, describing a hypothetical event that occurred when our universe had just been born. The postulators of this theory think that when our universe dropped out of this inflationary phase, it was just one of the bubbles amid a million or billion other bubbles. Together, these universes comprise everything that exists: space, time, matter, energy, and physical laws. What goes on inside black holes? The universe is full of mysteries. Perhaps one of the most fascinating yet mysterious is black holes. A black hole is a region of space that contains abnormally large amounts of mass where gravity prevents anything, including light, from escaping. The only way scientists can observe the impact of a black hole is when it's devouring space bodies like unfortunate galaxies that have found their way into its path. What do you think would happen if you fell into a black hole? For starters, you would never come out. The intense gravity will shrink and distort your body horizontally in a process called spaghettification. The universe is a hologram. The holographic universe is based on the idea that everything we experience here on Earth can be thought of as holograms projected from images on a two-dimensional surface, like the characters from Star Wars, if you will. A hologram gives a deep insight into the behavior of light. It is a physical object that allows you to see a ghost image of the light source. A hologram, when it catches the light, shows you not a standard two-dimensional image, but a three-dimensional image whose relative distance to your eye changes as you change your viewing angle. Some scientists believe our universe behaves that way. According to this theory, everything in our universe, including time, space, and matter, is encoded on a giant 2D surface. As crazy as it sounds, researchers are still digging. Recently, a team from the University of Southampton proved the idea of a holographic universe is consistent with the observed pattern of fluctuations in the cosmic microwave background. The world will end in a big rip. There are many theories and speculations as to how the Earth will end. If our star, the Sun, does not consume us, we could eventually be dragged into the great attractor. Either way, the world will end somehow. But there's an even more insane theory of how the universe will end: the Big Rip. The Big Rip theory postulates that if the universe expands faster than light can traverse it, all objects will eventually be torn apart. The Big Rip is theorized to occur when dark energy becomes dominant over all other forces, including gravity, causing space to expand faster than the speed of light, tearing apart everything, including stars, galaxies, atoms, subatomic particles, and even space-time. But the Big Rip isn't happening anytime soon. From calculations, it'll take at least 2.8 billion years from now. Space-time is not abstract, it's physical. Space-time is widely thought of as a mathematical model that combines the three dimensions of space and one dimension of time into a single four-dimensional manifold. But some theories hold that space-time isn't just a model frame of reference. Instead, a physical reality made of atoms. To them, the fabric of space-time is made up of tiny vibrating strings, sometimes called superstrings, so small they cannot be seen with even the most powerful microscopes on Earth. Stefano Liberati of the International School for Advanced Studies and Luca Massioni of Ludwig Maximilian University say space-time is similar to an ocean of water with zero viscosity. Just as water is made up of countless molecules, space-time is made up of microscopic particles on a deeper level of reality than our instruments can reach. We are living in a simulation. From Interstellar to Tenet, Christopher Nolan has an intriguing way of playing out some of the craziest universe theories. His 2010 movie, The Inception, captures a simulated world born out of the simulation theory. In Joel Silver's Matrix, we see Keanu Reeves living in a computer game controlled by the architect, a simulated reality. The simulation theory is a philosophical hypothesis stating that reality, or at least the reality we perceive with our senses, is an artificial simulation of the world. The idea has been explored by philosophers, scientists, and writers for centuries. If this theory were true, it would mean that all of us are really just virtual characters in a massive video game being played by some unknown force or entity. It could be God, aliens, or another form of life that we cannot yet explain. Too bad this theory has no substantial proof. Time is slowing down. We always say time waits for no one, but theoretically, time is, in fact, slowing down. It's a phenomenon that has puzzled scientists for years, but now researchers claim to have solved the mystery. Supernovae and galaxies aren't moving away from us, we are slowing down. So, light is taking longer to reach us. Their theory leaves no room for dark energy or dark flow. Even though this theory may be true, time will not stop until another million years. We won't be here by then.